What was, because like you were famously on Celebrity Rehab, but like what was the, I mean, you didn't come out of there like totally changed from that, right? Like when was
that season of Celebrity Rehab was the last season. And the people on the show weren't all addicted to drugs or alcohol. I was on there for codependency, which was clearly seen with my situation with Kate at the time. So, and then you had people in for sex addiction, you had people in for gambling, you had people in for, you know, all different kind of addictions on the show. So, people thought it was all drugs and alcohol. And that's another problem. Once you admit in your life that you drank or you did cocaine or you get a DUI, right away they label you as an addict. I was never an addict. Did I drink and did I party when I was a kid? Yes. Did I stop when I got married to Dina? Yeah. When we got separated, did I do it again? Yeah. Then was I clean again? Yeah. When we got separated again and got divorced, did I do it again? Yeah. I mean, that's not an addict. That's a person who chooses to do it. Was it the right choices? Absolutely not. I don't encourage anyone to drown their sorrows and numb their pain with alcohol or drugs. It doesn't work out. It's not the right medication. The right medication to me is God. That's what got me through everything, and I still lean on. But, you know, we all make mistakes. But there's then again, that's another false narrative that's out there that people just don't understand.
What, that you...
with addiction and so on, is that, you know, if you admit that you drank or, you know, you did drugs in the past, that you're an addict right away. And then when you go on Celebrity Rehab, they're, oh, well, he's on Celebrity Rehab, so he must have a drug problem. No, I was on for codependency. So that was it.
That is a false narrative. What about when, you know, Lindsay's been very open about her own struggles and like her sobriety. Like, what about like as a father, you know, you're dealing with it in the public eye, you know, and there's this narrative about you and now there's all this stuff about her. Like, do you feel like, I don't know, like I've created this because it's like I had my own struggles with this? I mean, I don't know.
No, I think, look, it's still so controversial whether addiction is genetic or not, because you can have two parents that are addicts that have, they can have four kids, only one is an addict or two are an addict or none are an addict. So everything is relative. I think that in everyone's life, I think that if you did have an addict in your family or an alcoholic, that gene is in you. And it's a matter of whether that you flip that switch of addiction to turn it on. Is there a traumatic moment that where someone has a weak moment and they try drugs or alcohol? And when they do, that's when they flip the switch and it becomes active. It remains dormant in some people and they never, you know, it never happens for them. So I'm not a scientist. I'm not a doctor. All I know is I've dealt with it for a while, you know, with other people as well as, you know, me going out. I believe it's a choice. You decide whether you want to drink or if you want to do drugs or whatever. At the end of the day, it's a choice. Why is it that someone can, go to rehab once, party for or use for 15 years and go to rehab once and they get it right the first time? And some people go, they do the same thing and they go to one rehab and then they relapse and another one that relapse. And maybe on the fifth rehab, they get clean. It's a choice. You decide to stop, whether it's an epiphany in your life or that traumatic moment, whether it's a near-death experience or jail or going to, you know, whatever the case may be, an overdose, it doesn't matter. It's a choice. You decide you're not going to do it anymore. And that's exactly what my daughter did. That's exactly what I did. I chose never to drink again. She chose never to drink or do drugs or anything. And we've been clean.
What do you say to, you know, there was this big controversy when Demi Lovato announced that she was California sober. Like, I mean, Aaron Carter just passed away. He said he was, you know, and they found, you know, Xanax in his system. No. Like, do you know?
No. Listen, if you're clean, you're clean. You can't switch one addiction for the other. You can't say I was an opiate addict, but now I only drink alcohol. And let's not make any mistakes. Adderall.
You went silent for some reason.
Horribly addictive drug. So if people think that they're okay when they're taking 2, 3, 4 Adderall pills at a time or a day, no, you're not okay. You can't do that. And another thing that gets me about that is when, you know, my daughter got, you know, she partied every once in a while. She got caught with cocaine in the car that time. And right away, they classified her as a drug addict and so on and so forth. And it was really wrong the way they did that, because they really beat her up over it. And then you have Demi Lovato, an overdose and stuff like that. And everyone applauded her when she got sober. But, and God bless her. That's a wonderful thing. God bless Demi, and hope she stays sober, but does it the right way, not the California way. But no one ever applauded Lindsay when she got sober. It was horrible. All they did was beat her up. It was really, the way they treated her was really, really, it was wrong. It really was.
I mean, I never thought about that, but you are right. I mean, like, they, the cocaine in the car, and then, right, they beat her up. Why do you think then with Demi Lovato, it's such an applause, and with Lindsay, it was such a chastising of her?
I don't know. I guess, you know, when someone's using drugs and they get arrested for it or something, it's one thing. But when someone actually overdoses, then they look at it as in a different light. That, like, oh my God, this person almost died and they survived. So let's get behind them. Let's support them. Let's cheer them on. And that's right. You should do that. But if someone gets arrested and they have drugs on them and they get their life sobered up, why not say the same? Why not say, hey, listen, you're an amazing actress. You're a star. You know, you had this bump in your life. We're going to support you. Let's stay on the right road. They didn't do that. No, they just kept beating her up.
No, they didn't do that. I feel like they still don't do that. You look at like Amanda Bynes, like there's just certain people that they just don't want to get behind, right?
No, and they look, they did it with Wendy Williams for so long. They got behind her. And look, it, no one wanted to say it was a drug addiction. And I, behind the scenes, I was calling everyone saying, because I met with Wendy a couple of times when Lindsay did a show and spoke to people. And I'm like, listen, she needs help. Just, I know what's going on. I've been doing this for 16 years. You can't pull the wool over. No one can pull the wool over my eyes. I can tell if you're drunk or high on the phone, just talking to you now. I know it's just something inside of me. I have an addiction detector built into me. And I was like, you got to get her help. It's going to get worse and worse. And it did. And they just wanted to hide it. But when you come, you know, it's a shame, because I'll leave that alone.
Who did, no, I mean, that is what, I mean, who did you tell that, hey, Wendy Williams needs help? Like people at the show?
Yeah, a couple of people. Yes. Yeah. Yep. People very close to her. Let's put it that way.
And that's the same kind of thing, right? Because there's people around her that I imagine are making a ton of money off her show and her personal life. I'm sure they're making a ton of money by being with her. Absolutely. It's true enabling.
Yeah. I mean, there was, what made me laugh is Lindsay did her show one time, and Lindsay was sober as sober could be. And Wendy was talking about Lindsay's shoes. And she made a comment, and she was like, oh, remember that time that you had, they said you had cocaine in your shoe or something, you had powder in your shoe or cocaine. And Lindsay said, I put powder in my shoe. How stupid can they be? And Wendy was kind of mocking her, making fun of her. Wendy was high as a kite that day she was interviewing her. I was like, can you believe how high she is? She's whacked on coke. And she's actually talking to Lindsay about Lindsay doing coke and how wrong it was. No, it was very hypocritical. But I hope she gets better. I really do.
I mean,
a big part of your sobriety and getting better is honesty. And you're not going to get better if you're not honest about it.
And I mean, she has not really come out.